ja, we zijn niet bij de samenwerking in de range between 400 en 900 manier. So, I don't know if I can...
What is the material you're measuring right now? What is the measurement you're doing now?
So, now we measure the photoluminescence of silicon nanoparticles. Yeah, embedded in the electric matrix.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, in the visible branch.
Silicon particles, right?
Silicon particles, yeah.
Are they spherical? No?
Not exactly, but we think that they are spherical.
So you produce the silicon particles here, or
no? In collaboration with another laboratory in France or in Algeria, and we can produce. So we don't produce directly silicon particles. We deposit silicon carbide or silicon nitride there.
Uh-huh.
By PECVD or by magnetosputtering.
Yes.
And we anneal the sample at different temperatures.
Okay.
To form silicon nanoparticles.
I see.
In the matrix,
in situ.
Yeah.
In situ.
Yeah.
In situ. Okay.
So, and we measure the optical response of the samples with photoluminescence or with UV visible spectroscopy with different. So here. In the general case, to measure the band gap of the nanoparticles, which depends on the size.
Size,
yeah. Yes. Yes.
So, what is the size range now
in hand? The size is between 3 nanometers and 15 nanometers.
Oh.
But it depends on the sample, of course.
Of course, yes.
Yeah, when we prepare the samples, we vary the parameters, the deposition parameters, and then we can change the size and the. Not exactly the size, but we cannot speak about the size, but the size distribution.
Okay.
And the average size of the of their particle, because
it's,
we have
not monodispersed.
Yeah, okay. Of course. And the band gap or the photoluminescence peak depends on the size distribution.
Okay, yeah.
So in general, we obtain a photoluminescence band which is.
Large, wide enough.
But the main peak shifts
depending on the size.
Yeah, of course. We studied the quantum confinement effect, which can occur in the size in the silicon nanoparticles when we decrease the size and the Bohr
Yes.
For silicon, it's around 7 nanometers, I think.
Okay.
7 or 10 nanometers.
You can also determine the defect levels in
your... Yeah, of course. We changed different parameters, for example, the excitation wavelength or the temperature of the... The measurement temperature, we can obtain more and more information about the surface.
And the exciting wavelength depends on the band gap.
Of course, yeah, of course.
So, what is your target? What is it? Are you...
So, the first target is to obtain, to evaluate the variation of the band gap as a function of the size. And, on the function of the deposition parameters, because when we change the deposition parameters, we can vary the size, and then we can vary the band gap.
Okay.
So the first target, but we can also obtain information about the defects in the matrix, because the signal has to be embedded in the matrix. In the oxide layer. So we can obtain information also on the defects or the defects in the layer or the defects at the interface between the same nanoparticles and the membrane. But it depends on the experimental parameters. I mean the excitation wavelength or the temperature of different other parameters.
What is the chemistry of the
nanoparticles? Korea TV, we analyze two sets of samples. I mean, the silicon particles are deposited with PCVD or by magnetic transmitting.
It's work PCVD.
No, PCVD in gaps. In gaps.
Gaps. Ah, yeah. Okay.
In collaboration with the Professor Kevin Feldman.
Thank you for this explanation.
You are welcome. Silicon dioxide, silicon nitride, aluminum dioxide, and we can deposit metals to form contacts. So when we need to make electrical measurements, we need to deposit the contacts such as aluminum, gold, silver in the front or in the rear face of the sample. So it's an evaporator, so which can be used to deposit a large gam of materials.
I see. Yeah. You can control the thickness of the.
Of course, yeah, of course. Okay. We change the deposition time, and we can control the thickness of the layer.
Well, I hear this is a new machine. Already have such machines. Anything new about this particular machine? Any particular advantage?
There's no particular function. It's a standard one. I mean, there is no particular option in this machine. We can. The advantage of this machine is that we can deposit a lot of materials.
Wide range of materials.
Yeah, a wide range of materials. Of course. Yeah. But for different purposes.
So, what is the temperature range you can operate?
I don't know because je ne peux pas utiliser.
Ah, mais c'est spécial. Mais dans ce domaine, il varie sur température.
Personnellement, je ne l'ai pas utilisé. Au carnet, il dit pas ce que j'ai.
Professor Sturu uses this machine. They use a density of current between 0 and 200 amperes.
Ah, I see.
They vary density of current, and then the temperature
rise and.
Thanks for this explanation. I can use this. 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 I can use this
Japanese?
Yeah, yeah. No, just English. It's just English.
Yes, just between Nagoya and Kyoto.
Ah, okay.
Just in the
research.
I'm a material scientist working on the synthesis of nanoparticles, metals, alloys. So that's why I was interested in that.
Which technique do you use to
I use a solution.
We will have a lecture tomorrow and conference by Friday from 9 a.m. I will give them a certificate that can use it for LMD.
Tomorrow?
Hematite.
Merci.
La
parole
de
la spine.
Spine.
Yes. it good?
We put the attached by
vacuum.
Yes. And here we have the excess of solution.
And you can choose the number of the
program speed, acceleration.
Sri Lanka.
Oh, okay.
So I live in Japan.
Which university?
The University of Shiga Prefecture.
Shiga, I know. Shiga.
Okay.
I did my PhD in Kyoto University.
Oh,
I have so,
yes. Thank you. So it's earlier I was in Tohoku University. You know Tohoku University?
Yes.
I was in Tohoku University for 15 years. I moved to Shiga University 5 years ago.
No.
So you were in Japan? Ah, yes, I've been there for a long time.
Yes, the research facility there is very.
Well, then you may be able to read it.
I forgot. Katakana.
So to know more about the land you can go to
Japan.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Talk is going to be the after, but tomorrow lecture for
PhD.
Okay.
Non,
Et lui, c'est le
thème.
Le thème.
Oui,
Doesn't need a lot of
sophisticated
instruments.
Yes. Yes.
Good way.
Thank you.
We go to the fuel cell. I'm going to go to the hospital.